Shanti.
Jeff, how are you?
How are you? Can you see me? Can you see me okay?
Yes, can you see and hear me okay?
Yes, I can. Thank you.
Okay, good. Want to jump right in?
Sure. I'm more amazed that 14 trainers couldn't get your dog to walk on a leash.
Yes, I know. It's like a world record.
Huh? That's a world record.
I was so desperate because, I got the dog. She's four years old.
Okay.
Since 2 years, I have her.
Okay.
She's from Spain, so okay. She was not socialized in my environment.
Okay.
And she's a nervous dog.
Okay.
But I'm a little confused because when she meets other people, she's very open.
Yes.
She can drive the subway and the bus.
Yes.
Being inside is fine. But when it comes to the sidewalk,
okay,
with the apartment buildings on the side and the street, she's so tuned out and I can't get a connection to her. And she's not reacting to any corrections. She's not taking food.
Right.
And there was no way to train her outside.
Okay.
And when I go to the park, she's a good off-leash dog.
Yes.
Yeah, she's got a good recall. And but she's still nervous, but exploring her environment and sniffing and playing with dogs.
Yes.
But when she's on leash, she's getting nervous right away.
Yes.
I think because she cannot flee like she wants to. She feels trapped.
Right.
And she's shaking then. And so since 2.5 years going out with her is like, horrible. It's always sad. She's never enjoying it. And I tried a lot of things. You know, I had 14 trainers and I tried almost everything on the pure positive side.
Yes.
But nothing made her like, oh, being outside is cool. Ah, okay.
Right.
Maybe if I sit here and watch for 1 hour, it's getting better. No, it's getting worse.
Right.
She's loading the more she's seeing something.
Yes.
And she's totally reacting to noises.
Yes.
And her default behavior is walking fast, fleeing, pulling, not reacting to something I do. I'm totally not there for
okay.
her.
Okay.
And being outside in the dark is impossible. So in winter times, I stopped walking her at 4 p.m.
Yes.
So we're just being inside, and I did not find any way to make it comfortable for her outside.
Mm.
Now she's on a prong since 2 months, and walking her is better.
Good.
Yeah, she's not pulling that hard.
Good.
But she's still pulling slightly.
Okay.
And she's not as tuned in as I hoped for her.
Right.
She's like, oh, okay, I cannot pull that hard, but I still want to go away, and she's not, there's no change of state of mind walking beside me. She's scanning all the time, sometimes so hard that she's losing balance.
Right.
While she's walking.
Right.
And she bumps into my legs because she has to look what's behind her. It's
right.
Always behind her. And if I stop and put her in a sit, she cannot turn her back to the way we came from. She has to turn around and looks the way down we came from.
Right.
And And I got an e-collar here since November. I got the mini educator.
Okay.
And I worked her inside.
Good.
With all the obedience, like sit, come, place.
Excellent.
All that, and kennel up, and being polite when she comes out.
Good.
And she loves to work with me. She's so tuned in inside.
Right.
But when it comes to the outside, it's like Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde.
Yes. Okay. So when you walk, so remember the tools are just the tools. The tools are neutral. Always remember that. They're neutral. They sit there. If you put them on a table, they do nothing. If you put them on a dog, theoretically they're doing nothing unless someone, which will be you, guide those tools to do what you want. It's very common that when you put a prong collar on a dog that things immediately get better, but it's also very common where they it doesn't do all the work. So you still have to give the prong collar instructions on how to work, and then the dog understands. Most people, what they do is, especially with a nervous, fearful dog, is they underwhelm the dog with the tool, because the dog is outside. And you called it right. It's like, we use a lot of positive, I don't want to get technical because we don't have, but we use a lot of positive in our training as well. But a fearful, nervous dog is not going to take food. They won't. They're more concerned about everything else. Praise, if anything, praise, they won't even notice praise. They will not even notice it because, again, they're so concerned. They're deaf and blind almost because they're so, so what you have to use is you're going to have to use what's compulsion, which is like, you know, a good strong pop. Most people struggle with that concept, but we've done it thousands of times with huge success. The reason why some people will struggle with it is because you've got a nervous, fearful dog and you're correcting it. Well, yes, you are. You won't make the dog worse. The dog already sounds like it's having a rough time out there struggling as it is. What's missing is lack of leadership. And you're probably not doing it on purpose, but you might be doing it because you're using too much heart and not enough head. Because we all feel bad about nervous, fearful dogs. We don't want to make them worse. Either do I. But the leadership has to be, when the dog is walking and it starts getting ahead of you or it scans, what are you doing?
I gave her a pop. So I trained her inside and in my building. So there she's fine walking on the prong.
Yes.
Head is behind my leg.
Good.
But outside, she's not even reacting to the pop. She's always sliding in front of me. And I think I'm underwhelming her.
Yes, you are underwhelming her. Remember, inside is different than outside. So inside is more calm, more quiet, not as many distractions. Outside, the dog's nose and ears, even though we just said that the dog is, you know, blind and deaf when it comes to, you know, affection, but its nose and its ears go into instant overload. So you don't even exist anymore. Nor does the collar around its neck exist. So what you need to do is you need to give a very strong, you're correcting the bad state of mind. Correcting before the dog appears to be nervous. So literally as soon as you walk outside and as soon as that dog starts scanning, correct. Firm. There might be an audible. Mm-hmm. And
that firm.
Yes. Okay. Now.
I didn't try
yes,
that firm.
That firm. Imagine if you were every day you saw somebody that looked like an ex-lover. It was a terrible relationship. And every time you think about that ex-lover, you start getting agitated. And you know, if you keep thinking about that ex-lover in 10 minutes, you'll literally be like punching a hole in the wall because you're so frustrated. And every time you start feeling that about your ex-lover, say your current partner says, you know, Shanti, just relax a little bit. I need you to relax. And it doesn't work. But if you're, and that doesn't mean your ex, the, I mean, isn't your current partner should slap you in the face. But what it means is, wouldn't it be nice if somebody could overwhelm those thoughts, squash them down so you don't think about that every time. That's what you have to do. Because you know darn well where you're going to be in 10 minutes. You've always been there in 10 minutes. It's the same thing with the dog. You know, okay, maybe you're hoping that it gets better, but it doesn't get better. So you have to squash it immediately. At the first sign, at the first sign of that dog going, correct. Now, I've heard it all, but some people will say, oh, now you're gonna make the walk not fun. The walk sucks. I mean, what do you mean? It's been sucking for 2 years. It's like,
it's sucking anyway.
Yes,
right.
It's not, it won't get worse, which doesn't give you permission to be mean to the dog, but what it does is, we have a track record of doing this with that exact same dog. Like your dog we've seen so many times. What it needs is, right now it needs that intense leadership that says, you're not allowed to think about that. Stop thinking about that. Stop hearing that. And get that dog to go into follow mode, which is what you're working on inside the house. You need to do that outside. So now the dog is like, all I care about is Shanti. nothing else matters. As long as she's here, I will be safe. Now,
okay.
How do you do that? You're going to have to do that through compulsion. Compulsion meaning technically force.
Yeah.
Because no reward is going to snap through that. None. And if anything, it could make it worse. Because rewards, you know, praise can hurt and it can help at the same time. Now, once the, and with the remote cower, what you would do with the remote cower, you do the same thing with the remote cower. Yes, you give a high level stim at the first sign. You're literally trying to break a cycle of addiction. Your dog is addicted to this behavior. So just like cigarettes, drugs, alcohol, self-harm, any addiction, you know, you're trying to break the cycle. And in order to break the cycle, there has to be a life-changing moment. So what are you going to do? You literally have to give that dog a big wake-up call. Now, will it get messy? With a dog with what you described, after doing this for 2 years, it's not going to get messier. It won't.
Yeah.
It won't. It
yeah.
Won't. Your dog will probably have maybe a little bit of confusion at the beginning. Mm-hmm. And then your dog will go, but Shanti's confident. And she's walking down the street all confident. And she's not bothered by all this stuff. And she's like leading me in the right direction. I guess I should pay attention to her. Because right now your dog doesn't know you exist when it's on leash outside. It doesn't know. If you drop the leash, what would your dog do?
She would run away.
Yeah. That means you do not exist. So you have no purpose outside on a walk with your dog right now. So what you want your dog to do is, if you drop the leash and you stop, your dog goes, oh, Shanti stopped. I guess I should stop too. Hey, Shanti, what's up? Like, that's sort of like, that's what you're looking for. Whether the dog is trained or not, that's what you're looking for. That means the dog knows someone's on the end of the leash. So many dogs have no idea there's somebody on the end of the leash. They just pull too hard. It's not always nervous. It's not always fear. But you're going to hear a lot of stuff. Well, you've probably already heard it all after 14 trainers that you should make the walk fun. You can't make the walk fun. If you hate roller coasters, oh, come on. No, there's a lot of fun on the roller coaster because I love roller coasters. It doesn't work that way. So as soon as you walk outside, knock it off. You're literally correcting the nervousness and fear.
Let's just ask you something maybe before the time is over. I was thinking about how can I train the e-collar, or how should I start? Should I start with recall or with e-collar heel? Because I have to go somewhere where it's a little bit less distracting.
Yes.
And I would train there, and then I have to go home with this, which is more distracting. I was confused how to realize this.
Start doing it on heel. Remote cower healing. So your dog knows remote cower inside, right? Your dog understands it? Okay.
Yeah.
So do it on healing. So what you can do is, every time your dog starts going, what's that, what's that, what's that? You say, never mind, never mind, never mind. So now your button is going to be the don't pay attention to those things button.
Yeah.
All right. You're trying to break the cycle. So what you're doing is you're telling you actually are correcting your dog. So your dog is nervous. It looks over there. Correct. Oh, hi. How are you? That's what you're looking for. You're looking for that dog to break the cycle. Then you can also focus on the remote cower healing. That's the first thing I would do. I would do that. And I would do it in quieter areas if there's such a thing as a quieter area around you. I mean, outside is outside. So I would do that. Also, stop going to the off-leash park on your walks for a couple weeks.
Okay.
I know you want to, the dog has fun there, but think about it. You're rewarding the dog for lots of fearful behavior. So what we want to do is, let's from now for 2 weeks straight, only do leash walks. That's it.
Okay.
That's it. Until we have to break this cycle of, I need you to pay attention to me. I need you to pay attention to me. And you can even go as close to the park where you go now, maybe, but then turn around and go back home or go the other way or change up your route, things like that.
Okay. So, but no going inside the park with the leash? Just
don't go to it at all.
Okay. It's no dog park, yeah? It's just a normal park.
But if the dog's off leash though, right?
But I can put her, I can let her on leash.
But no, the point is the dog is doing really well there, correct?
Yeah.
So no more, not for 2 weeks.
All right.
The point is you can go back there eventually, but right now I want you to focus just on this.
Okay.
Let's get rid of this 2 years of nonsense. Then we can talk about going back to the park where the dog is having fun. It sounds mean, but it's not mean. Listen, I'm trying to break a cycle. And right now the cycle is you're stressed for 10 minutes, then you run free, and then you're stressed for another 10 minutes to go home. I don't want that anymore. I want you to learn how to be relaxed, then enjoy the park, and then when we go home and be relaxed. So let's fix that behavior before we reward that dog with off-leash play. It's not forever, but it's just 2 weeks. And do it, and don't be afraid to go high on the remote.
Okay.
Don't be afraid.
Got it.
You're not, you won't mess up your dog. You won't.
And should I go out in the dark as well? Because we don't do it. It's horrible for her.
Yes.
Remote color healing in the dark.
Yes. Yep.
All right.
If you never push the dog's boundaries and push your boundaries, you'll never get better. It's impossible.
Yes.
It's not possible to walk. The dog's not going to wake up one day and say, I love walking in the dark. It just won't happen.
Yeah.
So you've got to do it. You got to do it. And we've done this. We've done this so many times. We've seen so many dogs like yours. And the only reason why I say it, like literally, this is like how we do it. And it works. It works.
Okay, good. I feel well prepared now.
Okay.
I'm ready to do this.
Good, Shanti. And just keep me up to date.
Okay, I will.
All right?
I will.
All right.
Thanks a lot.
Okay,
bye-bye.
Bye-bye. See you.
Bye.
Bye. Thank you.